Hello, ViteConf. My name is Ari, and I'm here to talk to you about code coverage in Vitest, how to use it, and how to get started with it. I'm part of the Vitest core team. I've been working on Vitest for the past 2.5 years now, I think. I'm also working at Stackblitz as an open source engineer. You're going to find me on GitHub and X behind these usernames. Now, what you can use code coverage for? It's a useful tool to see which parts of the source files are being executed by your test code. So by default here, Vitest will include your source files in the coverage report and mark them as uncovered. So when this file now doesn't have any test cases covering it, so we can see that everything is marked as red here and the coverage levels are at 0%. And once we start to add some test cases there, we can see that now our coverage levels are increasing, and we can see that the lines are now marked as green here instead of red. And once we add some more test cases, the report is now more green, and we can actually see that this line here is turning from red to green, which means that we are passing a threshold there. Now on line 7 here, we still have one place that is not being executed by our test files. Now, code coverage is useful to spot these kind of places, like if you now went and added a bug here on this line, like let's say that you changed this meow here to woof. Now, after change like that, none of your tests would fail because this is not executed by any tests. So you can add bugs in your source files without even realizing it. So code coverage is a good tool to spot this kind of error-prone or bug-prone places. Now let's see how this works in practice in Vitest. Here I have the same setup as shown earlier. We only have the Vitest installed here, and the source file is the same one. And we have, let's actually comment out this one. All right, so we have one test case for it. And now if we run npm run test coverage, we can see that Vitest is throwing us an error saying that the coverage provider module is not installed. But let's press Y and install it. And now Vitest automatically installed us the package. Now the reason why this one is not included in the core package, the Vitest one, is that coverage is an optional feature. Maybe some people don't use it, and it requires some extra dependencies. So we can reduce the package size of the main package by adding this as its own package as pair dependency. Now let's rerun the command. And now we can see that tests ran and there is a coverage report. So here at the root, we now have a coverage directory which has index.html. Let's open this one and close the sidebar. All right, so now we can see our coverage report here. Now we are only covering the first part of the source file, like the first if clause. But if we add another test case here and press save, the watch mode of Vitest instantly rerun the file and generated us a updated coverage report. And now we can see that the lines 6 to 8 are also covered. And we can see that there is still some parts of the source file that are not being covered by any test cases. So ideally we should add a test case for that one too. Now Vitest tries to provide good default options out of the box. The idea here is that users wouldn't need to configure anything. It would just work without any configuration. But for example, in a project like this, where we have a couple of files here and a single test case, and this test case here is importing the math.js, which is coming from here. Now, when we run coverage for this test case or this project, we will get a report that includes all of these files. So even though we are only importing the math.js, we are getting all of these other files in the report as well. And this is because Vitest enables the coverage.all option by default, which means that it will go through all of your files that are matching the include and exclude, and add those into the coverage report as uncovered files. But as we can see here, this is not actually an ideal situation because the docs and scripts directories, those are not our application code, but they are still included in our coverage report. So what we typically see is that users start to add all of these patterns in the coverage.exclude. And quite quickly, this can become a long list of options or patterns that is difficult to maintain. And this is not really ideal. Like, sure, this works. Now you are not seeing these in your coverage report. But if you now added another directory here or some file, it would also pop up in the report and you would have to define it here. So what's better is to help Vitest to find your source files. So instead of defining plenty of exclusions, just define couple, maybe even just one inclusion. So you can help Vitest by telling it where your source code is. Now we don't have to go through all of the files and then add them there. We can just simply start by looking from the SLC directory and then apply the exclusions there. This will make your coverage report generation faster also. Now we cannot really set the SRC here as default because it's not a convention that everyone does. Like, some could have the code in, let's say, packages directory or LIB or something like that. So you need to help Vitest to understand your project structure. Now Vitest comes with two coverage providers, the Istanbul and V8 one. The Istanbul here, it does the code coverage instrumentation using Babel, which means that it takes your JavaScript source code and adds plenty of, well, more JavaScript there. Like, here we can see I have the same files. And let's take a look at what happens to the source file. So originally this one was just 12 lines. And once we run it through Istanbul instrumentation, we can see that the file is increased a lot. Like, this is now 200 lines. And for example, here is a branch counter that is inside that if block there. And this is just a way how we can cover that. Okay, now increase the counter by one whenever we execute this if branch here. While this works perfectly, it's quite slow. Like, you can imagine in a larger project, these files can grow like huge and executing them can become slow. But the reports are very accurate because the instrumentation is AST based. Like, we can understand what the coverage actually contains. This is something that Zest does by default. By default, Zest has the coverage provider option with value Babel, which is the same as Istanbul on Vitest. And it's the same that NYC does. Now, Vitest has also the coverage V8, which we use by default. And this one is a bit more modern approach to coverage. So it does the instrumentation on V8. And V8 is the JavaScript engine that is used by Node.js and Chromium browsers. Now, we don't have to make any modifications to those source files before we execute them. We can just instruct V8 that, okay, before you actually execute this, start your own internal instrumentation and collect the coverage reports from this. And this one is really fast. But as it is not AST based, it's not something that we don't really control the instrumentation or how it is done. It is not as accurate as the Istanbul reports are. But in Vitest version 2, we were able to add features that actually improved the accuracy of V8 coverage reports as well. Like, right now we can exclude TypeScript types, empty lines, and so on. This is something that Zest supports by the V8 coverage provider option, and C8 does the same, and the Node built-in test runner with their experimental flag has the same features. Now, we recommend to use V8 coverage always. Like, if you are running your code in Node or Chromium browsers, use V8. But if you need to run your code, let's say in Cloudflare Workers or Firefox, then you can use the Istanbul. Or if you are doing migration from Zest and you don't want to see plenty of changes in the same migration, you can use the Istanbul first and maybe later change the coverage provided to V8. Now these are just some features that we've gone through now, like the basic options, but Vitest has plenty of coverage options like thresholds, workspaces. In workspaces you can see the coverage report of both browser and node in the same report, which is really cool. And custom reporters, custom providers, you can build one of your own coverage provider yourself. And Vitest UI is able to show the coverage reports in the browser itself. And so much more. All right, thank you, ViteConf. I hope you have a good day.